Hello and Saudi Cup. Welcome everyone to the second and final day of the Southeast Asia Major here in Bangkok, Thailand at the Pantip Esports Arena. I am D2. Joining me is the lovely Patra Cadness. How are you doing, Patra?
I'm great. How are you?
Doing good as well. We have a pretty nice group of players left today. This is Championship Sunday. And what kind of players are we looking forward to seeing here left over? We have a lot of countries actually representing.
Yeah, actually, we are down to the top eight in the winners brackets. Mm-hmm. And GG Leo from Singapore is still in, facing Leda from Thailand. And yeah, Leda, as you know, is the Southeast Asia preliminaries winner, summer winner. Mm-hmm. And then who else do we have still in the brackets? We could actually look at the event schedule.
Right. Yeah. So we do have the quarterfinals of the upper bracket right now, followed by the semifinals, and then going on throughout the day, all of the important matches for you here. And then finally, at the very end, the grand finals to see who will take home the $2,500 grand prize, and potentially, if it matters, the 15 Hearthstone Championship Tour points. Now, actually, we had GCT Tirth from India fall out of the bracket, so there's actually one player remaining who can benefit from those points and actually make the last call tournament, the top eight tournament at the end of the year, which is the last chance for players to go to BlizzCon. That is Throne. We were struggling with his name yesterday in Chinese. He is the player from Hong Kong, but he is in the lower bracket. After we cast him, he actually just fell to the lower bracket, unfortunately for him, but he still has a chance here. And as far as our first match coming up here, we do have Chonger versus Kin0531. Two pretty good players. Chonger kind of known in the Southeast Asia region with some of his results here. As we take a look at our upper bracket, and a lot of tiny names here, because this is the first round on, or maybe the round of 64 on, actually.
Yeah, so as you can see, there's Leda, GG Leos, He Is Not Axel, and Shy. There is...
it gets really small.
Jackpot and Go Gong Sing.
Right.
And then in the lower brackets, we still have Neilio, The One Jack, Chung FR, and Nook Style. Still, well, there's even a couple more others, but you guys will... you can just check on the brackets by typing exclamation point bracket in the
Absolutely.
Chat.
Absolutely. And actually, after the broadcast ended yesterday, we had players just continuing to play and fill out that lower bracket, because there's so many matches to be filled in here. I believe we have eight in the upper bracket and eight in the lower bracket left over.
Actually, they had a really long day yesterday.
Right.
I found out, because I'm friends with some of the players, in the lower brackets, they ended around midnight.
Oof.
So
yeah, the casters were done at 9. So. All right. So this is our match coming up here. Looks like we have a ban on the warrior here from Chonger, and as far as Kin is concerned, his shaman has been banned. And considering we're not going to see those classes, we can go ahead and tell you what they were. Chonger was going to play at N'Zoth warrior, so that has been banned out. And Kin's shaman was an aggro shaman with one lightning storm and zero maelstrom portal. So we see what these players are trying to avoid here. And let me just tell you about Chonger. He won the SEA Legends last year in 2015. He actually got second in the WCA Pro Qualifier. And he earned $3,000 for himself for that event. As we take a look at Kin0531 from Hong Kong, Chonger also got third/fourth at the winner SEA Preliminary. So he almost made it to the APAC Championships, just two matches away there. And actually, at the Singapore Major, he got fourth place. And as we do take a look at Chonger, on the other hand, Kin, not as well known in these major tournaments, but I did look him up, and he actually has the third longest top 100 streak in Asia, and I think he's actually number four overall in the world, four or five, something like that. He had eight straight top 100 finishes from the end of 2014 to the middle of 2015, and his highest finish was number five on the Asia server.
Yes, we know that like a lot of players that we can just look up on Google, and they have Wikipedia pages, but for some people, they just don't have Wikipedia pages yet.
Oh,
so
feels
like
bad.
You need that person, someone to write it for you, or you could do it yourself.
Right. There is actually a site out there that you can go ahead and look up how many times people have finished in the top 100. So yeah, pretty good streak there for Kin, but that was in 2015. Let's see if he can, you know, have his first result of 2016 here, taking on Chonger in this quarterfinals of the upper bracket. So big opportunity for both of these players to pretty much make a name for themselves.
Definitely. And going back to their deck lists, we are going to see the Dragon Warrior for Kin and the discard.
The Disco Lock. We have the Karazhan Thea, right?
Yeah, so the discard Zoo, and actually he runs the Councilman in it, but no Ritual.
Right, right. Then Forbidden Ritual is typically cut these days, but yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, usually they don't even discard Zoos, don't run Councilmans, but some of them do. And then you got the Token Druid, and with Chonger, we're going to see a Druid also, but his is a Mali.
Right.
And he has the Aggro Shaman, and the Hunter.
Yep,
more of a mid-rangey Hunter.
Yeah, pretty standard Aggro Shaman as well. Just one Lightning Storm, one Maelstrom Portal, and the Hunter is a list that has one Argent Squire, one Abusive Sergeant, double Fiery Bat. So a bit of a, you know, people playing around with that, with those 3-1 drops.
Two Argent Horse Riders in the Hunter, yeah.
Yep, exactly. And one Barnes, no 5 drops. People have been cutting all the 5 drops at this tournament, which is, I guess, is pretty standard these days, but feels bad, man, when you can choose from, you know, Stranglethorn Tiger, Kodo.
It's a bit slow.
It's a bit slow.
Still, yeah, it really depends on their kind of strategy.
Never Kitty Cat, though.
Wanna Kitty Cat?
The Stranglethorn Tiger.
Oh, because there's another cat, you know?
Plenty of
cat trick.
The cat trick, yes. We are going to go into the game soon here. It looks like we are. And yeah, these players have chosen the Dragon Warrior for Kin first, and Chonger has decided to go with the Shaman. So it looks like Kin has kind of won out on the pick here. This is a bit of a favorite matchup for him, and Chonger does not look happy at the moment.
Well, yeah, Chonger needs to find some of his early minions, and Kin actually was looking for a dragon, but he did not get the dragon synergy up there for his Alexstrasza champions.
Right, and he only has one more draw in order to be able to coin out that Alexstrasza champion on turn 1, as we do see that great graphic with Thrall and Garrosh. All right, Chonger has a pretty reasonable turn 1 here, just going with that Tunnel Trog. And
yes, I could actually hear the crowd outside getting excited, because I think they're getting excited because Chonger's starting hand looks great, and Kin doesn't actually have anything to take out this Trog yet.
Right. A dragon off the top there would have been a brutal punish here for Chonger. It actually was a decision to make whether he went for the Abusive Sergeant, as strange as it sounds, because, you know, maybe you want to bait out the removal on it. All right. So it looks like the choice there was the Paladin and the Shaman, as well as the Mage here. So Mage looks like, I mean, pretty much the best one by far. You want to be able to ping off stuff with that hero power. And as an aggressive deck, you don't really miss the armor up that much unless you get pretty far behind.
Right. I actually think the Mage hero power for Dragon Warrior is one of the best, because you have the option to ping, execute, or even ping and activate your Grom. Or just help pinging off some minions off your opponent's board.
This is the nightmare for the Dragon Warrior. You get all of the minions that benefit off of dragons and none of the dragons in your hand. I feel like one dragon in the hand, if that rag was an Azure Drake or any dragon really, then Kin would have been in an awesome position right now. But as it stands, just needs to sit here and figure out a way to deal with this board. It's likely to be either a 2-3 Alexstrasza champion or just a coin into the monkey. But
I felt like he was a bit greedy with his mulligan, like keeping 2 Alexstrasza champions and a monkey and just only taking out one card and hoping that one card would have been a dragon.
That is a really good point that you make, because he actually does have 2 Frothing Berserkers and 2 monkeys, as well as a Ravaging Ghoul. So very good chance he actually picks up a 3 drop, even if he mulligans away that fierce monkey. So I have to agree with you there that I think that keeping the monkey in particular was, you know, a bit greedy. All right, well, on the side of Chong here, a few options. He can go ahead and Abusive plus Lightning Bolt and clear this board and keep both of his minions alive if he so chooses, which is pretty nice, obviously. He can also go for Maelstrom Portal, and he does keep both alive at the same time, but drops both of his minions to 1 health and 2 health, respectively. So it's pretty tough.
Yeah, and I mean, like, getting the, being able to only use 3 mana next turn is still fine for Chonger, because he can still just use the Tusker.
Yeah, and so there's also, the point to make that maybe he goes for the Abusive onto the Tunnel Trog, takes out the Monkey, and then Lightning Bolts the Sir Finley, just so no execute can happen unless there's a commit to the thing here. So, all right, he does end up going for the Maelstrom Portal, Portal in the end. Gets a 1-3. Obviously, unless he gets Healing Totem, he's not going to be able to use that Northshire Cleric. But that said, it is actually kind of threatening here for Kid. You know, he kind of wants to kill it before a Healing Totem comes out.
Right. And this is just sometimes this kind of thing happens where you just don't get any dragons until like turn 8 or 9. It's just very sad. But I think he's going to have to. He could hero power down the totem golem and even use his blood to ichor on the.
Right. The issue. The thing is, this seems weird, right? Because you would normally blood to ichor onto the Northshire Cleric. Okay, he's going to go ahead and ping away the Tunnel Dwarf. But a lot of times you would ping the Totem Golem and then blood to ichor the Northshire Cleric to get them down low, you know, if that was a standard 1-3. But that allows your opponent to get double draw, potentially, if a Healing Totem comes up. And actually, right. There are 4 out of 7 that are great here. Speaking of the, you know, obviously the 3 non-hero totems, and then the Healing Totem is great here.
Wow.
Does get the Totem Golem. So
that's practically like a 6-6.
Yeah, that's pretty insane. Yeah, 6-6. That I saw someone make a graphic out of that, right? Just the Tuskar Totemic, just 6-6. Those are his stats. Those are his baseline stats. No big deal. All right, Kin. He needs a dragon. Picks
there
up the dragon, finally, but a bit too late. I feel like he could have controlled the board extremely well up to this point. Does get to kill this Northshire Cleric, so no drawing 3 cards from here on out. But Chonger still in the driver's seat as of this moment.
Yeah, that's right. And we were probably going to see him drop down the thing from below on this on his turn 5, which where he's overloaded for 1 mana crystal. And he can just trade off his Totem Golem into the Alexstrasza Champion.
One thing to keep in mind. Yeah, exactly. One thing to keep in mind is that there is no armor up anymore. So every single point of damage is permanent. There's no armor smith either. There's nothing like an Alexstrasza, for instance. So he could just go face here. The one thing to keep in mind for Chonger is that he knows now that his opponent has finally picked up a dragon. And the Alexstrasza Champion came off the left side. So now Chonger's thinking, okay, he actually had those in his hand the entire time. He just finally picked up a dragon here. And that makes it a bit more difficult because if there's a Black and Corruptor, which we see is in the hand, then he can go ahead and take out the thing from below with that. So Chonger deciding to go ahead and trade here, which ends up working out in his favor because, again, the Black and Corruptor would have been a pretty reasonable punish.
Yeah, I do like the trade there because the Blackwing Corruptor could just kill his thing from below, but here he's going to just Blackwing Corruptor and kill the
Tuskar,
yeah. So he can just ping down later the 3-1 Totem Golem.
Right. It would take 2 turns of Healing Totem to be able to get the health above that anyway. Wow, that's a friendly faceless. All right. Kin's going to need Execute right quick after this, because I feel like this card is coming down.
Actually, he could he could just put the Flame Tongue and...
Well, he can get the value trade, too, with the Totem Golem.
Yeah.
Right? And then the thing is, even if your opponent has That's Execute, typically they need to use 3 mana to do that anyway. And your opponent's left with 3 mana, which means they're not doing much. And you still have a 7-5 thing from below, as well as the Flame Tongue Totem. So I feel like the Flaming Faceless, this is one of the safest times to put it down. Your opponent really can't deal with your board no matter what.
Actually, yeah, that's just exactly what I was going to say. I was going to say he's going to put down the Faceless, the Flame Wreath Faceless with the Flame Tongue and the trade off the Totem Golem into the Blackwing Corruptor and go face with the thing from below.
He could actually go face as well, though.
Yeah, but I wouldn't because it's right. Mid-range versus mid-range pretty much. Or well, actually well, it's aggro versus... It's all about controlling the board. And we know that Dragon Warrior is actually favored against any type of shaman. Mm-hmm. But it's just that Kin did not get his dragon synergy at the start, did not get the Fiery War Axe. Could not use the Alexstrasza Champion, so this is why he's behind right now.
Yeah, it's always nice to set up lethal on board as well. And that is going to be it. Kin does not pick anything off of the Drake, not like it would have mattered anyway. 1 mana to his name. And that's going to be game here for Chonger. Takes the unfavored matchup, which is extremely important for this series overall. He's going to go up 1-0.
Yeah, that was a very... it's a very simple game when the Dragon Warrior does not get the Dragon Synergy.
That's basically what the game came down to, right? Just
yes.
If he got the Dragon Synergy, felt like him would have been in a really strong spot there. Obviously, Chonger picked up some really nice cards to help out his curve and make things really awkward. But, you know, if he had to deal with Alexstrasza Champion 2 turns in a row, you know, coin into that minion on turn 1 and on turn 2, things would have been a lot different, would have been much harder for Chonger to develop onto the board.
Right. I'm sure Kin definitely wanted to defeat his aggro shaman with that deck, but it didn't work out for Kin. But we'll definitely be seeing that Dragon Warrior again And it could do okay against... it could go... It's pretty much 50-50 against Chonger's Hunter. And it could do okay against his Mali Druid.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of situations where a lot of the top decks just kind of do reasonably well against each other, right? We're in this meta where there's no extremely polarized matchups, with the exception of when, you know, Freeze Mage pops up. And so, yeah, he could just definitely go with the Dragon Warrior again, but it wouldn't be a heavy favorite against either of the decks that Chonger has remaining. It would just be reasonable.
Yeah, it's okay. 50, like 50-50. Mm-hmm. It really depends. I mean, I feel like Druid, Token Druids or Mali Druid can do okay against Dragon Warrior if they get their ramp. Otherwise, they'll be in trouble. Mm. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, basically. Yeah, that is something to keep in mind, because the Malagos, if they don't get the ramp, and there's actually one Mire Keeper, if I remember correctly, in Chonger's deck, and there's no taunts. There's no Druid of the Claw, there's no Ancient of War, just all of that burst damage at the end from the Malagos. So you really really have to get into a good spot and keep up with the Dragon Warrior, or else, you know, there's no putting up an Ancient of War hoping they don't have Execute and essentially clearing their entire board that way. So it makes it a little bit more difficult for the Malagos Druid. So, you know, that all said, probably going to see Kin just bring out the Warrior and hopefully it goes against the Druid. But on the side of Chonger, maybe he, you know, decides better and goes with the Hunter.
Yeah, anything goes. I mean, either way, you have to win with each of your decks. And
just go to random, what is that side? You go to the random, you know, the RNG. Basically, the dice roller. Or you just have a dice in your pocket, or a die in your pocket, and just roll that and go with that.
Or you just close your eyes and click on a deck, except for the banned.
And then you
one.
Click on the wrong deck, yeah. And then you get disqualified, and then, yeah, it feels bad, man.
Yeah, your banned one.
Yeah. Automatic disqualification.
Yeah, well, but I mean, a strategy for Kin against the Druid could just be like, all just go keep smorking, and then maybe eventually he could just... Since there's no taunts anyway, right?
Right. The hardest thing about that you're playing Druid against the Dragon War is actually the Fairy Dragons.
Oh,
those
yeah.
things are just a pain, because you need to actually get on board first. And if you actually, and that's the Dragon Warrior, if you continue to clear the board and leave space for your Fairy Dragon, you can't kill it. There's no way to kill it unless there's some sort
a
of spell damage.
A swipe and a hero power.
Right, exactly.
It's the only way.
Turn
Druid.
Six, we did it. We finally.
I know.
We only took 18 damage from that Fairy Dragon.
Or I mean, your living roots can, like, your saplings.
Right,
can
but
take
then
you're,
but then he plays Ravaging Ghoul, and then he goes face again. Then you have to use two mana to kill off the Fairy Dragon. Then you're taking more damage from the ghoul. And then you go home and cry and kind of get in the field of position because the Fairy Dragon has beaten you into submission.
Yeah.
That's the latter, guys.
We'll see. It all depends on what cards they have in their mulligan.
Yeah, absolutely. The cards in the opening hands of both players certainly does matter. I'm not really sure what the delay is. I think they're just choosing their next decks. Obviously, a lot of mind games.
Yeah, they're just taking their time thinking it really through. Actually, I was thinking that each person was going to ban either a Shaman or Warrior. That's usually the go-to, right? Mm-hmm.
All right, well, it looks like we are finally going to get into the game, and it's going to be the Disco Lock here from Kin. Gonna change it up just a little bit, and on the side of Chonger does decide to go for the Druid in the end. Keep in mind, these players both, or they know the contents of each other's decks, so Chonger is not going to be mulliganing potentially for any sort of Reyna lock or what have you. Knows exactly that this is the discard lock on the side of Kin, and will mulligan appropriately.
So here we go. Chonger has his Living Roots and his one Mire Keeper in his deck. I do like the Mire Keeper. He could actually just like mulligan out the Arcane Giant, even the Living Roots and the Raven Idol, and just look for more ramp, but I guess he's going to keep the Living Root for an early start. I guess the Living Roots is actually great against the discard zoo.
Yeah, the Living Roots is excellent. The Raven Idol, not as necessary. I think the Mire Keeper is definitely a good keep because he knows he doesn't have any more Mire Keepers in this deck. And drawing another Mire Keeper can mean that your start's a little bit slow. Also, one thing to keep in mind is that he's going second, so he can coin into the Mire Keeper on turn three, which is pretty powerful. He's going to go for the Coin Wild Growth instead, though, and looks like he's aiming to Living Roots something down next turn.
I totally don't disagree with this, because against an aggro, it's okay for a Druid to coin into wild growth, and sometimes that's actually the winning player.
This is a big deal. 1 in 3 to get another 3/3 on the board with this Darkshire Librarian. And he also draws a card, so. Wow!
Oh my gosh.
Oh my goodness. Okay, and draws a card. 0 downside. Just gets a 3/3 on the board with that Silverware Golem.
Sometimes lucky, you know?
Yeah, Chonga throws out the well played and starts to hug his pillow a bit because he's going to need that reassurance, that comfort.
He could Living Roots and Hero Power down the 3/3.
Right, yeah, and then you're leaving the Darkshire Librarian. That's the worst thing about this Darkshire Librarian, right? Because it's already produced a 3/3, drawn a card with the Malgazar's Imp, and if you kill it, it gives your opponent more field because it draws a card. Pretty insane.
I have to think the Moonfire looks pretty good here. But
yeah.
All of them actually look pretty good, but I'm guessing he's thinking of Norris to just ramp up.
Ooh. It's kind of hard to ramp up, though, when you're facing down 6 damage on the board already. This is more looking like Swipe. I suppose you can go for the Starfall for a pretty big clear. Also, it's something that your opponent won't expect. And let's go for the Starfall. So it's kind of the surprise element, right? Even though and he's looking at the Mire Keeper next turn. And after that, he can go ahead and Starfall when, you know, his opponent really isn't expecting that sort of board clear and just leaves his board at 2 health.
But it's actually going to be really tough for Chonger to come back because that swing alone at the start with actually discarding the Silverware Golem was a huge swing.
Yeah, absolutely. And the thing is, if you look at Kin's hand, he just has refill for days. Once you clear this board, he's like, all right, I got another Darkshire Councilman. I got another Inking boss. I have Knife Juggler plus Direwolf Alpha. I can trade into any minion you have on board and just get a bunch of damage you face as well. So, you know, Chonger, even if he tries to come back here, every single turn for the next 4 turns I'm looking at, Kin's going to have something crazy to do.
Definitely. So we are going to. Yeah, he's got 2 choices here. He can just play the Imp Gang, or he could put actually the Juggler and the Peddler.
Right, he could put the. If he plays 2 minions here, obviously he can get a kind of a value trade with his Dark Tower Councilman onto the Mire Keeper. That does leave it vulnerable to Starfall, especially if he plays, you know, any of his. Well, basically all of his 2 drops, right? They're all at 2 health. So a Starfall, would be able to clear both the Darkshire Councilman and both of those 2 drops here. So we'll see. That
definitely can't play around Starfall,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
If you're in Kin's position.
Right. This is exactly why Chonger picked Starfall, by the way. He figured it would be a big surprise for the opponent. And I believe we're going to see... Well, Malgazar's Imp could actually go in now instead.
Yeah, that actually seems better.
Just to play around any sort of craziness. Kin saw 2 Raven Idols, so... He's a bit concerned, and you can see he's thinking about it.
I mean, you always want to usually go face for more damage, and now Chonger's actually nodding his head. He's like, this is great. I could actually kill 3 minions with the Starfall.
Well, as good as you can hope for, considering he's in such a bad position to begin with. And Kin says, you know what? Even if he somehow picks Starfall, he's floating a mana, and I'm still going to have a 3/3 and a 1, or excuse me, yeah, 1/1 that draws me cards. So... It's not the worst situation for Kin, even the worst case scenario.
I mean, it's also nice because Chonger could just swipe later, like a next turn, possibly.
Right, right. And that's what Chonger's thinking about. So, yeah, it looks like Chonger's found a way to make this a game after that crazy start here from Kin. Kin's going to decide what to do this next turn, and you can tell he's a bit worried about that swipe. Can't just go for the Darkshire Councilman, but... That would leave him vulnerable to the Swipe plus Hero Power.
Right, it's either a Councilman into Peddler or the Imp Gang and the Peddler.
Right. So this is going to be his board now. Obviously he can't play the 1 drop after this, which means that Chonger, if he picks up an Innervate, just clears the board. And this draw is pretty huge here. Hasn't picked up an Innervate all game and does not either this part. So... as painful as it is, you really want to develop the board, but... Oh, okay.
Maybe he's hoping to...
This is very risky on the side of Chonger, because there's quite a bit of burst in the discard log with the Soulfires and the Doomguards.
Actually, yes, it's very risky. His Councilman could just keep growing and actually trade into the Teacher.
Well, 8 damage on board, and there is 2, 3, 4... 5 more damage in hand. If you so, yeah, 13. 2 damage off lethal here is in, if I've done my math correctly. He could also get a value trade onto the teacher with the Dark Shower Councilman, but you're leaving yourself open to the Drake Swipe. So yeah, look, going back on Chongo's turn, he just really wants this Drake Swipe to do a whole bunch of work. And he just says, you know what, I gotta take a risk here. And if I go for the safe play of Swipe, then I'm leaving myself open to the Drew just flooding the board again.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I understand Chongo's play. Akin has many options, but he's actually just thinking what is the best thing. And I know he's definitely keeping in mind that his opponent has a Swipe. And
yeah,
he's thinking of the best way, like which is the best minion to actually buff up with the Defender of Argus.
Alright, he's going to go at it this way, which leaves him somewhat vulnerable to Swipe here with the spell damage.
And I actually agree with like not trading into the teacher at all.
Right.
Because if he does have a Yogg, and he's going to, like...
Oh, right, yeah, he's concerned about Yogg, you're right. You're absolutely right. Sorry, go ahead.
His whole board would just die, right, possibly to Yogg, and also the Yogg could just kill Chongar's face.
Yep. So Chongar looks like he's going to go for the Drake Swipe. Really no way around it. Wow, if he had one more mana or some sort of coin or innervate, this would be pretty ridiculous, but unfortunately not here. And can Chongar stay alive, actually? Can't
Feral Ray? Oh, no, no.
No,
he can't. He can't.
Because the, yeah, the
yeah,
Defender
he can't
of Argus.
Swipe.
Defender of Argus and the White Walker lives there. So well played by Kin being able to navigate that and brings it back to 1-1.
That's usually the case. Like when you're aggro facing the druid, all you just want to do is go face before you see that Yogg come down and destroy your board.
Yeah, exactly. It feels safer to clear the board, but when you put your opponent on such low health that anything can kill them, then all of a sudden they have to, you know, bend over backwards just to stay alive, mm-hmm. And that's value in and of itself.
And you know that little argument of people like saying, oh, you can't play around Yogg, but you know, people are sort of kind of playing around
Yeah, they're
around
figuring out how to do
Yogg.
It, right? They've counted the spells. I think at that point it was like 7 spells played, so not totally guaranteed to, or not very likely, I should say, to clear the board. There's only things like, you know, Flame Strike or Twisting Nether or Doom that can actually clear everything. Other than that, it's just a bunch of, obviously, random spells in random places.
Definitely. I mean, yesterday, TJ and I were casting a match. It was Temple Mage versus Temple Mage. And it basically felt like your fate depended on whatever your Yogg was going to be like and his Yogg was going to be like.
Right. And then there's also the consideration about, do you play your Yogg first? Do you wait until their Yogg so you can clean up their Yogg with your Yogg?
No, you make a board first and then hope.
All right, looks like. All right, so guys, if you want to talk about this tournament, go ahead and tweet at just put Hearth SEA Major and join the conversation. We'll put your tweets on the screen here.
Yeah, tell us which players you want to see make it to number one.
Make it to that $2,500 first place prize and the 15 points. I got to say, I'm rooting for the Story of Throne just to be able to win and get into the last call.
Oh, you're going back from your draft.
Oh, I don't actually.
You made a draft with all of us.
Wait, who did I pick actually? Oh. I forgot. Well, Ping was already out. Oh, I picked Tom.
You picked 2 Taiwan players.
Right,
and
but
so Tom's
out.
Out. Yeah.
Yeah. So
I still have.
Yeah,
I still
exactly.
have my player. Gigi Liaz was one of my picks. So, and he's in the winners. So,
yeah.
Looking forward to possibly seeing him, you know, reach number one.
All right, you're a better fantasy esports Hearthstone drafter than I am. Yeah, we did have a little pool between the casters. Well, not for any money, obviously, but yeah.
No, you're buying drinks. You're buying drinks now.
That is news to me. But, well, I guess by picking 2 players, I've already gone out. I kind of like my picks. Actually, Ping Ping Ho, TJ and I were really disappointed after we saw his decks. We're like, yeah. Aww.
Well, you know what? He is the shaman god, and I figured he's bored of playing the normal shaman decks, mm-hmm. and he wanted to bring something more creative. And if it worked, he would have been the shaman. He would have proved himself as the shaman god. I actually met him, and it was very delightful.
I went down to talk to some of the players yesterday, and Krennic was already just talking to Ping Ping Ho, saying, yeah, your shaman's bad. What are you doing? What are you trying to accomplish with that? And Ping Ping Ho's reply was, well, as bad as it did today, I beat everyone on ladder with it. So
I guess just because it's going well on ladder doesn't mean it's going to do well in the competition, though.
Yep, absolutely.
Game number three, and Kin has got his druid against Chonger's hunter.
Yep, this is the token druid. No Malagos stuff in here. Just looking at the list here from Kin, there's one Moonglade portal, there's two Ancient of Wars with the Yogg and the Thalanos, and two Arcane Giants as well. So got that power in there. Some of the players yesterday were preferring the Druid of the Claw in place of that, but those players are out of the tournament.
Yeah, there's a lot of different druid, token druid decks, Mali druid decks. Still, people are still playing around, seeing which is the best one, but pretty much all of them are pretty good, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
all these spells and the Yogg.
Yeah, the Beast Druid doesn't perform that well, but
the Beast is fell kind of short. People were actually saying, "Oh, this is Beast Druid is going to be so OP," and then when we actually got to try it, it felt like it was lacking something.
Right.
And then
enough OP cards, basically.
Then they started adding Violet Teachers, Fandrills, Power of the Wilds, and then it's next thing you know, it's like, let's just throw in the Yogg, and then
and
next
take
thing
out the Menagerie Warden.
Yeah, and then it's
like, oh wait, I've built a token druid.
Right.
So this is an interesting play by Kin, and very good pickup by Chonger here. So Kin was thinking that if he doesn't have a 2-drop, I can Wild Growth. If he does, I can Wrath. And is he able to use the Wild Growth here since the Kindly Grandmother isn't really providing much of a threat? But that pickup was extremely good for Chonger here. Now he can go into Animal Companion and almost guarantee himself a target for the Houndmaster.
Yeah, as a hunter, you just want to play on curve as much as you can.
Was it just me, or did I hear a huffer sound? I was getting... it sounded like a little snort. I'm like, oh wait, that's not... I guess it was the growl from Leog. Leog trying to be a huffer never will happen.
And just to get rid of this Leog and just deal with the Kindly Grandmother later, it's not really that much of a threat.
Until...
until it gets Houndmastered.
Right, the Kindly Grandmother, not even in its wolf form, will turn into a 3-3. Second Houndmaster could be a pretty big pickup if Kin doesn't decide to deal with this Kindly Grandmother. Maybe turn into a 5-5 pre-death battle. And yeah, it looks like it's going to be just a Drake here, which means that this Kindly Grandmother can get pretty big.
Yeah, I'm actually wondering if Chonger's strategy is just go face, or actually I think he might have to trade into this.
His deck isn't
Drake.
Completely aggro based, so he can sort of play the late game. Obviously with Call of the Wild, you're going to be able to do that. So Kin decides not to go for the Innervate into Living Roost to take out the Houndmaster here, wants to save that Innervate for later. And Deadly Shot comes into the hand of Chonger. He does know that his opponent runs the double Arcane Giant as well as the double Ancient of War. So unlikely to see the Deadly Shot here since it's not super necessary. He can get the value trade with the 5-5 Kindly Grandmother or trade in his Houndmaster. Either way, just thinking of the best way to go about it. He could actually play on curve as well and just go for the bow. But the thing is, weapons have charge, so you don't need to develop it right now.
I actually don't mind the Deadly Shot here, though. I mean, if he deadly shots this and just plays the huge toad and then just goes face, and then just Houndmasters something later and hero powers, you know, that's still a lot of damage.
Right, yeah. 7 damage to the face would bring the opponent to 15. Your opponent would need Innervate into the Ancient of War to be able to get that. So, but he's going to go with, instead, the Eagle Horn bow. This is 6 damage to face. Look, probably going to trade here, also.
Yeah.
In a bit of trouble with that Drake.
This is also really good. Still allows him to deal a lot of damage, and he has an extra charge with that bow.
On the side of Kin, looks like it's going to be the Living Roots after the Drake. Going to kill off the toad instead, and this ping is actually pretty important. Does hit the Drake, which means that Chonger can kill it off with his face.
Ooh.
And well, he could just go all face, actually.
Yep, he can, actually. That's a lot of damage.
Yeah.
That's 10 damage to the face. I think he should just kill.
He can get his opponent to 6, and then he has Quick Shot Hero Power. If he does kill the Drake, though, it's very difficult for Kin to deal with this. He can't put up an Ancient of War because it just gets deadly shotted, so I don't think that the 3 damage to face is necessary. Chonger has time on his hands with that Hero Power. And if your opponent... The weird thing about the situation is going face actually gives your opponent more time, potentially, to do things like Feral Rage because they can more easily clear your board.
I actually, either option is fine, like whether he trades into the Drake or hits the face. But I mean, it depends also how like he's got two kill commands still left in his deck, right?
Right. I think that just Hero Power will win in the game though.
Yeah.
And there's only so many times that your opponent can heal up essentially. But does end up going face here. If he doesn't have the Feral Raids, then this ends up just being game for Chung. There's no real way to come back here for Kid, barring an Innervate into Yogg next turn, but only four spells have been played thus far. So I can see the thinking here from Chonger saying, you know what, you don't have much time, I'm going to give you as little time as possible. And on top of that, you need to clear every single minion if you don't put up a taunt right now.
Yeah.
Including the Big Bad Wolf.
Yeah, that's actually, I think Chonger made the right plays and just smorked it down before the Druid had a chance to do anything.
Yep, and this looks like it's going to be game. He can innervate into Swipe and then clear off the Beast or the Houndmaster, but that's going to be game regardless. Can't see any other play that would come closer to leaving him alive as well. So, that's going to be the Swipe, and going to leave up a 3-2. It's the exact same thing, it's just swiping the other way and killing off the Houndmaster, and that's going to be... On the side of Kin, he thinks he's one damage off dying, but quick shot in hand means that Chonger's going to take a 2-1 series lead.
That's right. He was just hoping that his opponent did not have a damage, but you know, knowing the Hunter, they most likely have some sort of damage waiting in their hand. That's why they went face.
Right. It was a tough situation regardless, right? Even if your opponent didn't have lethal there, you still have to get healing off the top. So, not the best situation there for Kin and Chonger. He is proving himself as a player who has consistently done well in tournaments. He got fourth place at the Singapore Major. That you were there, right?
Yes, the Singapore Major, yeah, he got fourth.
And he actually got third. He got to the semifinals of the SEA Winter Prelims, so he was two matches off getting to the APAC Championship in the winter stage, and that was the one that Staz won. He actually did lose to Staz in that tournament. So Chonger has been very consistent. Will he be able to get his first championship at a major LAN event here? He is one game away from going to the semifinals of the upper bracket and only has his Malagos Druid left.
Mm-hmm, that's right. He is actually one of Malaysia's top players, and that's why we always see him in a lot of tournaments on the ladder. And actually, he's on a team. It's called M8 Gaming, which is a Malaysian team.
Right. I believe that's one of the top teams in Malaysia.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure he represents them very, very well.
Yeah, he has done so very well at this tournament, certainly.
So he's on his last deck right now, and that is the Mali Druid,
yeah,
right?
The Mali Druid. As for Kin, he has the Dragon Warrior and the Token Druid left over. So two pretty strong decks. Kin is still in this thing. And what do you think that Kin should bring up here? Should he bring out the Dragon Warrior or should he bring out the Token Druid?
I feel like he can, either one is fine actually, but I think he should just bring the Dragon Warrior and just kill.
just win the game.
Or
easy reverse.
Yeah, I guess so. Or he could just, I think that the harder matchup for Kin would be the Druid against Druid, because it's a mirror match. And
right.
If he takes that, then I think his Warrior could have a slightly easier time. I don't know, like, I think Warrior can take it from Druid if the Druid doesn't get any RAM.
Yeah, I think I agree. I think I'd rather go with the Dragon Warrior this time around. If he does go for the Token Druid, there is the issue that your opponent's kind of playing with the added benefit of, you know, the old combo, right? You know, the combo did 14 damage. He has Malagos into Double Moonfire. You're always living in fear of that, and you kind of have to play very defensively if you ever get behind in the damage race. So a bit of an unfair situation there. You can grab the board with your bigger minions, but can be quite difficult. So yeah, we'll see what Kin decides to go with. The casters have argued for the Dragon Warrior.
Mm-hmm. But, I actually want to see the Mali Druid against the Token Druid, so let's see how these
just want
two decks
to kill him.
How these two decks face off together. Like, we definitely need to see which is the better Druid, you know, like, but you
one
need,
game sample.
Yeah, I mean, one game only. You need thousands of games to actually figure out which is the better deck out of the two. But I mean, I feel like you might as well just go with your the toughest match first and get it out of the way.
That's certainly. And the thing is, if these players want to be advancing to the later stages of the day, then they don't really want to be fatiguing. And there's no extra points for making the score close. So I certainly agree that, you know, given that they know the contents of their opponent's decks, sometimes when you don't know exactly what's in the deck, you're like, well, I might figure something out, so let's play the strongest deck, get that win in, and then
that's
play
true.
Afterward. But they know the contents of their opponent's deck, so might as well just get the shortest day in possible. If you lose, you lose now, and save your energy for later. They are in the upper bracket, so they still have a chance if they fall into the lower bracket there. And yeah, we can actually talk about the Dragon Warrior as well. I do like this list quite a lot. It tops out at Rag and Grom. No Deathwing, no Anixia nonsense. Just kill your face before turn 8. And one Ghoul, two Frothing Berserkers, one Nuzzaw's First Mate, as well as obviously the Sir Finley for that Curator synergy. And just, yeah, just kill you as quickly as possible.
Seems like a pretty standard Dragon Warrior. I feel like every Dragon Warrior has the Curator now, and it's just like mixing up whether they're going to have a Deathwing or keep the... Like, I know some people don't even play Grom in their Dragon Warrior, like that's a thing. And there's even... Sometimes they even use the Bookworm.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
I think people use Bookworm for about a week, and then they said, you know what, I think I'd rather have a 9-9.
No, so. I've seen people, there's people in this tournament that brought Bookworm in their Dragon Warrior.
They're still holding on for dear life. They're like, I think this is still good. Anyway, we are getting to the Druid versus Druid matchup. Not a mirror, it's going to be Token versus Malygos. Many of the same cards, obviously, but there is the difference in the Moonfires and the Malygos there for that end game burn. Also, no taunts on the side of Chonger here, so that's something to keep in mind.
Well, I'm happy Kin was decided to pick his Druid and thought, yeah, let's just get this mirror match sort of, well, not really mirror, but kind of the same class match, like, out of the way.
Yeah, a lot of interesting dynamics in this matchup as well. You know, for the dragon, you're just kind of trying to hit the face as much as humanly possible without getting punished, whereas this matchup, it's a lot more nuanced.
Yeah, Chonger's just going to wait it out here and innervate into his Mire Keeper.
Yep. Innervate Mire Keeper into the Fangirl the following turn, or coin into Drake if he feels like he has something better to do or doesn't want his Fangirl to die. Kin, on the other hand, has, you know, obviously the ramp on his side as well. So it's going to be Wild Growth into Innervate Mire Keeper into Mire Keeper. We're just going straight into turn 5 in this game.
Mm-hmm.
Chonger does pick up that Innervate, which helps him in the future potentially, especially with that Arcane Giant in hand. This looks like... Oh, okay. Just gonna go with the Fandral. It doesn't have anything to pair with the Fandral, but this is telling Kin, if you have a way to deal with this, you have to deal with it now, and could bait out the Moltres right here.
Yeah, I like that play of the Fandral. Oh, okay, he's gonna...
Yeah, he's forcing out the Mulch here. And the thing is, other than the Arcane Giant, there's nothing really else to Mulch. And Kin says, if I can get ahead on the board right now, then hopefully I can deal with the Mulches, or excuse me, with the Arcane Giants later. We have a Gorilla bot A3. I don't believe there's any mechs in the deck of Chonger, though.
He has the option to take out the Drake with a Azure Drake, Innervate into Wrath. But
yeah, does not go for it. If he does go for that, he doesn't have much of a turn next turn except for going for a 3-4 for 4, or essentially for 6 because you're hero powering.
Mm-hmm. I think the Ancient of War is great here and just trade into it.
Yep. And no real way to deal with this on the side of Chonger. Picks up a Wild Growth, completely useless right now.
Yeah, his falling turn was going to be kind of weird either way.
Is he going to go to Malygos or Arcane Giant here? Just Malygos, just tempo Malygos, let's go. He can Wrath the kill, I believe, so 3 plus 8. No,
well,
he can kill, kind of.
He's seen a Mulch, so he's not scared for his Malygos.
Right, that certainly makes sense. Very cool play here from Chonger. And the Wrath is 6, so he can actually just Wrath for the card draw, which is 6, and then kill off the Ancient of War here.
He wants to get rid of this already.
Right, and Kin's just going to go ahead and put as much damage on the Malygos as possible, set up for future kills. Even if his board dies, he does have the swipe in hand, and Feral Rage picked up here for Chonger, so he's going to go ahead and kill it off with the Wrath here. Kin go and Feral Rage to kill off the Drake as well, or Moonfire.
He could just Yeah, take it out with a Fel Rage. And does he want to do the Moonfire?
Just fireball the face for fireball face for zero mana. He could go for it. Maybe not super necessary, but.
Well, he doesn't know that his Malygos is about to die, so he thinks like it's best to just save it.
Right. The 6 damage to face doesn't really matter unless they're going to die anyway.
Yeah.
And it looks like Kin's not close to dying.
You'd actually want to use a Moonfire against like an Arcane Giant also.
I think that he maybe could have gone for the Moonfire onto the Dreyglasser and save the Feral Rage. It wouldn't be very mana efficient, but he could have played the Gralabot as well.
Yeah, he could have.
Well, in any case, Chang'er cannot deal with his Battle Teacher, even with the combined might of Moonfire, Living Roots, and Hero Power.
Yeah, that Teacher is going to live, but I think it is time to put out the Arcane Giant.
He can play Gorillabot, Moonfire, Arcane Giant.
Yep, that's totally fine.
Or he can also fill in the, or he can play out the Living Roots as well, obviously. But not sure how much value that would be. He can actually just prepare for Yogg next turn if he feels like his board might get cleared. So he might just go for all of it, other than Yogg. At least he is. So it seems like. Oh, no, just Hero Power. My mistake.
And then just play the Arcane Giant.
Right. Doesn't. Chang'er just hates his Gorilla Boss. He's had several turns of play. He's like, not good enough for me.
Awkward. I mean, it only has value really when you have mechs.
Just gets a mech off of the Yogg, no big deal. Alright, well, Kane is going to go ahead and Wrath for draw, I believe. I'm ready to
learn. I think it's time to bring out his Arcane Giant also.
What does that say on the Arcane Giant? It's kind of cut off at the top there. Is that a 6?
Seems like it is a 6 right now.
Probably a 6.
Because it looks the same as the Moonglade portal.
Right. It's kind of narrow on the right side, thick on the left side. Which means he can play it. Does it turn into a 5? There, it looks like a 5. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's pick up another Arcane Giant. Alright, we've gotten word from production that it is a 5 mana Arcane Giant right now, and could we see a Yogg right now is the question. The Arcane Giant, how much did it cost last turn for Chang'er? It was 6
It became
mana.
5
became
for
5,
Chang'er.
So he can Moonfire, and he'll have played 8 spells, but it looks like he's just going to go for the Raven Elder first. Wants to pick up Mulch, I would imagine. Gets Naturalized, which is not the greatest, but it does deal with the Arcane Giant. The issue here for Chang'er is that he doesn't know that Arcane Giant's already in the hand of Kin, so he might be giving him a second Arcane Giant.
He could actually even Mark of Nature his Arcane Giant. That's another option, and just kill
right.
the teacher for now.
Does use the Naturalize, excuse me. And just gonna push damage to face. Has already seen 2 Wraths, so just wants to finish out this game as quickly as possible. Particularly
yeah.
since he knows he's probably going to be Yogging next turn.
Yeah, we know that Chang'er's game plan is just to use all the spells and eventually just uses Yogg.
So it was 5 last turn. He's used 3 spells just now, so that's going to be 10 spells total. I mean, it was 5. The cost, it was 5. So.
Sandril, yeah, Nourish, Power of the Wild, but... That's if he can take another 8 damage to the face.
Yeah, he can't actually go Moonblade Portal into the Arcane Giant as well. The only issue there is that he can't kill off the Gorillabot in that situation. So you're kind of healing for 3 if you do go for the Fangirl Nourish Power of the Wild. And I don't blame him for going for this play. It's a bit more adventurous.
I'm ready it's to learn. Probably the best play. Maybe he can draw into more spells and
yeah, innervate would help him get out.
Wow.
Ooh.
This is so juicy for the Fandral.
This is pretty juicy, I have to agree with you. He's thinking about the Raven Idol. I think that Living Roots is pretty nice as well to get 2/2s onto the board for 1
he's
mana.
He's gotta do it fast.
He needs to really pick as quickly as possible, right? Arc
right.
Spider. Okay,
oh my
Mulch
goodness.
Seems good. Okay, Power of the Wild, take out the Gorillabot. Alright. Got it all done. And that's a pretty massive board. Yogg, you have your work cut out for you.
Okay, it's definitely time to Yogg now.
It is
but
Yogg time.
What is he going to do with his Arcane Giant? Is he going to
face all day,
face?
Every day?
My greeting.
Oh my gosh, my greeting.
Just don't even attack with it. Yeah, just don't even
no,
attack with it.
No, it's just it might
get
be a
the
waste.
Buff. Yeah, I know. I would attack face here and go with the... It's either attack the Fandral
oh, no.
or attack face.
This is so scary.
All right, just go ahead and attack the Fandral. Oh.
Huh? Oh no, he doesn't want to yawg.
That's not an innervate. That power level is not an innervate. He can't yawg yet. He's just going to wait it out. He has 22 health. He's not going to die, he says. It's pretty scary
he's
considering that.
He's being greedy. He wants to just use more spells, I guess. That I don't think he didn't do. He's just pretending, I think. I'm just pretending he made a mistake.
Yeah, yeah. Or just but he could be dead right now is the issue. 14 damage on the field.
No, I think he's actually pretending to just have no yawg in his hand, maybe. I don't know. But then
Kin is 4 damage.
Kin would be like, what is that card in your hand?
If he gets a charger off of the Moogly portal, he wins the game.
I don't know. It's pretty.
Rocket's Reckless Hero would win the game right now. Alright, just gets. Oh, 5. Not too bad. 5-5 taunt.
Yeah, that's a nice.
Not too shabby. And doesn't really need to use the mulch. You can just go ahead and play the Arch and Horse Fighter as well as the Living Roots, or just either. Also, Living Roots activates the Arcane Giant, so. Yeah, Kin is in an excellent spot, and this is even tougher for the Yogg to deal with. Good luck, Yogg. Now you really have to play Chogger. There's no more waiting.
Yeah, definitely. He's planning to play his Yogg, but if this Yogg clears this whole board, that's going to be pretty good for Chonger.
The thing is, he's played one more spell. I don't think one more spell is going to help him clear out this bigger board than last turn.
We'll have to see if whether that extra spell is going to help him or not.
All right. It's 1,000% Yogg. There's no way. And quick little prayer. I believe it's 11
Praise
spells.
Yogg.
I believe it's 11 spells. Freeze Trap is okay. Unfriended Portal is okay. But you need to start clearing the board. Shadow Word Death is great. Except it goes under the Yogg. Oh no. Explosive shot. Doesn't clear the best minions out. Forgotten Torch goes onto his own minion here. Tracking is meh. He needs some. He needs to clear
meh.
The board. That's not going to do it though. Power Shot. Okay, sure. Starts clearing off more damage. Okay, Mark the Vile needs to go on his own minion here.
No.
Does not. Refreshment Vendor says. Funnel cakes, please! Funnel cakes! Alright, well, this is pretty good. I think he. Does he get the freeze effect? I don't think so. Okay, he doesn't actually get the freeze effect.
It's a freezing trap.
Alright, so.
Freezing trap, though.
Yeah, freezing trap is on the board. Kin is probably going to play out or attack with his Violet Teacher first, just to see what it is. Explosive trap doesn't actually kill anything, neither does Misdirection. Oh, he can go with the Argent Horse as well, though, obviously. And 15-19. That is going to be game here. Kin is going to take it and bring it to game number 5. I can
see. Yeah, this long. Actually, all my games that I've been casting have pretty much gone to game 5.
The Hearthstone gods have shined
Wait,
upon
how did
you.
He get the Argent Horse Rider?
Off of the Raven Idol. That Hearthstone APM. Right? He was roping. He was deciding what to do, and he went Raven Idol with the Fandral. He went into Raven Idol. Could have gone with the Living Roots, but he's like, you know what? I believe in my APM. I believe in my skills here. Picked up the mulch, picked up the Argent Horse Rider.
Really and quickly.
And then played out the Power of the Wild, killed off the Gorilla Bot A3, finished out the game. Yogg, no problem. I can deal with Yogg.
That Horse Rider did its job against that freezing trap.
Well, Swipe would have won the game anyway.
Yeah, I know. It's just, you know, it was a good minion. If he didn't have Swipe, it was a good minion.
I want to see how good Kin is at StarCraft. Or any other high APM
Wait,
game.
So, what?
Because his APM is off the charts. Custom
I was
APM.
Like, what? Does he play StarCraft?
I don't know, but he'd probably be good at it with that APM. I mean, usually Hearthstone APM is like 5, maybe 4. You just click once.
I don't know. It depends. Like, if you're lagging, I know that you can't do your turns really fast. But if you have really fast internet, you could still do your turns even though there's animation going on.
Right. Except when it's, you know, pre-Warsong nerf and then you're playing with patrons.
Oh, yeah.
You have to wait for every single last one to go off.
That's
the best feeling
animation.
In the world in that era was clicking. You just didn't know what was happening and you kind of, you know, guesstimated the math, but then you click the Frothing Berserker to the face and there was just goes like, okay, got lethal.
Yeah, those were complicated days, but I heard they were fun ones.
They were pretty fun sometimes. Patron mirrors were kind of nerve-wracking. But
actually, I remember seeing someone's tweet, bring back
Warsong.
Yeah, Warsong Commander.
Right, getting into game number 5 here. This is a pretty big game for both of these players, and it's going to be, again, the Malagos Druid going off against the Dragon Warrior. Both of these decks have lost already this series, and they don't want, these decks don't want to be the reason why they fall down to the lower bracket.
But even though, I mean, they still have a chance if they're in the lower bracket.
Right, it's much more difficult, though.
Yes, it is.
It's like, would I rather be on my last leg here, the last match before I die, or be in a very advantageous position going into the semifinals?
But I feel like if you know that you played well and you feel like you didn't misplay...
No consolation prizes!
If you feel like you didn't misplay, then, you know, there's nothing that could have been done. You played your best.
All right, so Chonger here has actually a decision to be made. I kind of like going for the coin... innervate into the Violet Teacher. As Kin, you're not really keeping Execute. Yeah, you might be afraid of some sort of early innervate shenanigan, but really it's only Violet Teacher that's going to
right.
be out there as a minion. There's no, you know, Ancient of War, for
that's
instance.
That's a really good turn. Because there's no way a Dragon Warrior can deal with this.
Yeah.
I mean, the best thing that he could have is probably the Fiery War Axe and just like hit it twice.
Yeah, just take 9 damage. Mm-hmm. We were talking earlier how the Fairy Dragon is just the bane for the Druid decks because you can't kill it, but when you have Battle Teacher in turn 1, it's easy peasy.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, Fierce Monkey comes onto the board here, and Chonger does not pick up a 4 drop, but has that Raven Idol to go ahead and pick up a spell. Wrath would be pretty nice here.
Yeah,
as well.
Do you think he could pick up
Rage.
Anything?
Feral Rage, Wrath, pretty good.
Yeah, Feral Rage would.
Living Roots does clear and provides an extra 1/1, so probably Living Roots here. Or Mark of Nature. He can Mark of Nature onto his 1/1. Actually, he takes less damage that way, but yeah, Mark of Nature is actually just superior because he doesn't take any damage.
That's true. He could actually Mark of Nature his teacher.
Right. Would you though? It goes up to the 3/6 and then.
Yeah, you don't want to kill.
3/3.
You don't want to kill your teacher.
Right. Yeah, this is strictly better. It's strictly better, yeah. You're right.
And he's got the Nourish on the turn 5, which is actually really good for him. Anyways,
yeah.
Let's go into Kin's hand. Twilight Guardian. Or he could take out the teacher right now with Corcoran, but he's not actually
right.
putting anything on the board, just killing off something.
You are just leaving 2 1/1s on the field,
mm-hmm.
and your opponent either has Nourish or Drake as the best turns here. There is no Innervate into Ancient of War. There's Innervate into Arcane Giant, if he's been counting the spells. But yeah, the thing is, there's not much of a follow-up here if you are Chonger, so I think that you're kind of okay as Kin, just trading off.
Yeah, I think the Taunt is really good here, because this means if he doesn't have any more spells, and if he does just have the Nourish mm-hmm. on turn 5, then he's going to have to eventually... Chonger can't go through this Drake
right.
if he's gonna Nourish.
Yeah, and the other thing to keep in mind is that the Foul Teacher is probably not gonna be healing like it did last turn, so I'm gonna go ahead and take it out with the Black Green Copter coming up next turn. The slight punish would be a Power of the Wild. But Chonger, he's thinking about mana, I think. But he can just play an Arcane Giant for 6 next turn. I think he probably needs the cards.
Yeah, this is a tough call because you do have a Yogg in your hand too. But yeah, it's like you need cards.
If you can
or
help
you're going
to
play the Yogg.
If you can help it, you'd rather not rely on Yogg though, even though you've already played 6 spells. The thing to keep in mind, if he did go for mana, he could hero power down this Twilight Guardian, but I don't think he really cares all that much about the Twilight Guardian.
Oh. This is going to go ahead and help Kin there.
He's a bit worried about Ravaging Goal, also a bit worried about the Black and Corruptor. So this is actually a pretty good turn here from Chonger. Would have gotten really punished if he left up the Violet Teacher. And Chonger is feeling pretty good about himself. Obviously, he's sad that he's given up board control, but knows he made the right play last turn.
Chonger was actually playing around Ghoul.
Right, yeah, Ghoul. But he was playing on Ghoul by trading in the 1-1. He's playing around the Black and Corruptor by playing, trading in the Violet Teacher.
Yeah, he was. I feel like he could, well, because I see Kin's hand, he didn't have to trade in all the 1-1s.
Right.
Because Power of the Wild would have been great.
He was leaving it in a situation where he could hero power it down, worst case scenario. Did pick up the swipe, which helped him out quite a bit. But
yeah,
he could have gone
true.
For Fandral plus hero power, which would have been reasonable. And looks like we're going to have Alexstrasza Champion and Corcoran Elite to the face, but going to get pretty punished, I would say, by Fandral plus Feral Rage. Or you can go for the Wrath as well. Both are pretty reasonable here.
Fandral Wrath. Actually,
there can also be Wrath.
Either one is fine. But yeah, might as well just get the Feral Rage armor right now before the Fandral dies.
If he's trading, he made the wrong trade.
Oh, yeah. He took an extra damage.
It just looks better, right? You get your 4 attack, you want to kill off the Corcoran. But yeah, the 3-2 trades into the 4-3.
How did you even... you managed to notice that he went for the wrong minion before it even happened. How'd you do that?
How did I do that? Oh.
You saw the arrow.
Yeah. All right. Well, this is the power of Fandral. You force your opponent to trade a 4-3 into a 3-2. And yeah.
Double Arcane Giant this turn. It's pretty good.
8-8 for 3, not too bad. And Kin is, yeah, wow. Kin is not like this thing as hard as he can right now. He just really double Arcane Giant and came in from a reasonable spot to an absolutely horrible spot in just one turn.
Yeah, I think it was really
Execute,
that.
Though.
Yeah, that's actually really good. But it was really. It was that Violet Teacher at the start.
Right, yeah.
That just did all that work.
Yeah.
It made it hard for Kin to catch up.
Yeah, allowed Chang'ar just to play spells out for, you know, more value than you normally obviously get for it, because every single turn was an extra 1-1. Kin decides he's going to take out the Bloodmaid's Downloads. We do see in hand that the Wrath would have been a pretty big punish if he didn't kill that. But Raven, wow. Talk about feeding the Yogg.
I know. A lot of spells.
I wouldn't be surprised to see him cycle the Wrath here. But starting off with the Raven Idol, gets a Swipe, gets a Moonglade Portal as well. All of these are really good, actually.
Yeah.
I don't think you ever pick Bite over Swipe, but
it's his playground right now. Anything's good. Moonglade, heal yourself.
Heal yourself. The Wrath doesn't now kill the Drake, but that's okay because you get a 6-drop. Both is the card here, which is not that great.
You know what? He could have traded into the Drake and healed his Arcane Giant, but I guess he probably just wants to go face with the Arcane Giant.
Right. Just kind of pressure your opponent. If he does trade here, though, then it wouldn't make a whole lot of sense, but he's going to go ahead, take out the slime, make things difficult.
Oh, that minion.
The thing is, for Kin, he wants to just hit the face to kill off the bull for free, essentially, but he also needs to just kill off this Arcane Giant, so either way, it's just not looking too good here for Kin here.
Definitely. That's all of the Moonglade portals. Minions are pretty good. So now, no dragons in Kin's hand.
This does buff up the Frothing Berserker here. And for Chang'ar, that Power of the Wild's kind of nice. The issue here is that he probably wants to Power of the Wild before he Wraths, because then he buffs up the Frothing Berserker.
He's in a weird position now. It's like he doesn't want to Yogg because he's not actually behind.
Yeah. He can Yogg afterward when his opponent, you know, puts a rag on the board or something. But I think the correct play is to go for the Power of the Wild first and then go for the Wrath, because otherwise you're buffing out the Frothing Berserker. Or if you do go for the Wrath, it would be for 3, then you attack the Frothing first.
I feel like he needs the Power of the Wild first and then trade into the Frothing with his Bolt.
Oh, he forgot? This is interesting.
I guess he's just ignoring the Corruptor then.
Could still trade into it.
No, it's not going to. Oh, is it? Okay, I guess.
He has lethal on board right now if Kin can't deal with this. And let's see what the... Oh, does pick up Curator. That's one of the best cards in his entire deck, if not the best. Picks up the Monkey as well, obviously, because you're not going to draw anything else off of that card as far as beasts are concerned. So we could finally see a Yogg here, but Drake might... might make it so he doesn't go for it yet. He's not going to Yogg quite yet.
Not quite yet. He wants to get value for his Yogg. More minions, please.
Yeah, he says, deal with this. And then once you deal with it, then I can play my Yogg.
Right.
All right, Alex Charles Champion is the pickup here. I imagine Kin wants to continue to armor up. He could.
Yeah, I don't think he wants to get rid of his hero power just yet.
This is really tough for him, though.
It is. He's actually thinking, like, maybe I can just trade my Alexstrasza into the 9-5.
Right. The thing is, he needs to make that trade. He needs to make the awkward trade where he's really only putting one damage into it. He could try to get one damage off of the Surf Finley, but it would have to be Mage. It can't be Druid or Rogue. That would be problematic. So, yeah, he's just going to grab.
Hero power.
Yeah, just going to go ahead and grab the board here. No lethal for Chong and nothing to pick up really, so he... Well, never mind. Every time I think he's gonna Yogg, he picks up Hazard Drake.
Give him that extra card.
Could we see Moonfire to the face?
Nah, I think we just save it until the Mali comes.
That is true. I'm getting this game mixed up with the last game where Moonfire was used, or excuse me, the Malagos was used pretty
early.
Oh
no.
Oh my goodness.
That's not a good card that you want to see.
That is the worst card in the deck, I think.
Yeah, that's what you want to see in turn one. Not.
Alright, well, it looks like he's picked up the shapeshift here off of the Sir Finley. I think our production team told us that the other ones were the Rogue and. What was the other one?
Totem.
Totem, right. So, could have maybe gone for some Taunt Totems, but this seems a little bit better. I guess the guaranteed healing. And I think it's time, finally, for the Yogg.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no,
still
just
not
kidding.
Yet.
Just kidding. We're going to go ahead and kill off this Dragon and Crusher first.
Yeah, it's not a threatening board. It's just a Finley. And then he can just deal with this Nuzzoth's first mate.
I suppose if Yogg fails, then... Like, for instance, if Yogg plays, you know, Siphon Soul, all this kind of stuff, and then, like, Rag comes onto the field, then Chang'e could fall behind. I think Chang'e is saying, you know what, I'm in a pretty good position. I don't need to do this until I see Yogg or Grom. Or not Grom, excuse me. It's Rag or Grom. Getting these things mixed up.
Execute.
But
oh, wow.
I think we... Okay. Unless Chang'e picks up his third Drake, I think we're finally going to see Yogg here.
I feel like Twitch chat is just going, use the Yogg! Use
Yogg or
the
no
Yogg!
Balls! Yeah. All right. are we going to see Drake or is he finally... It could be Malagos. Oh, that's just lethal. Okay,
there
never
go.
Mind. No Yogg this game. Going to be just lethal with that Moonfire to the face. And that's going to be a hard-fought victory for Chang'e. 3-2 over Kin. He moves on to the semifinals of the winner's bracket. Kin falls down to the lower bracket.
And that's what he was waiting for. He was like, no, I don't need my Yogg to
that
win.
That is true.
I just need my Mali for this Moonfire that I've been holding for so long in my hand. And he got it.
Yeah. You figure he'd actually drawn pretty far into this deck and played a lot of spells, so maybe Yogg just punishes him and says, you know, sprint, fatigue to death. So
it was almost like a little bit of BM, like, because it was just so torturous. Like, he's actually so close to winning, and then it's just like he's leaving his... He could have played Yogg like many times already, right?
I think he just hates Switch Chat. That's what Chonger's trying to...
Maybe he just doesn't trust his RNG. He's like, no, my Yogg has always been terrible.
I would have liked to see him just look at the camera and say, no, Twitch Chat, no. And just...
torture
just,
his
just
Twitch
to troll
chat.
Them as hard as possible. I mean, Twitch Chat trolls people all the time. Might as well get him back.
By not playing Yogg.
Absolutely. Twitch chat loves nothing more than a good Yogg. They also hate nothing more than a good Yogg. You never know with Twitch chat. But anyway, that all aside, by the way, guys, let us know what you think about the tournament. We do have a... All right, so we do have a replay coming up. We had that's the production in my ear. But go ahead and tweet with the hashtag ParthSEAMajor as we get into our highlight of the game here, the very last play of the series. Malagos off the top. Moonfire does 6 damage. And Chang'e, well-earned victory there. Kin, obviously very disappointed.
Right, and definitely get in on Twitter and tweet us which moment you found the best, and also you can even talk about which player you want to see get to the top. So Hearth SEA Major.
Absolutely. Chang'e actually has a really good chance at this point. There's a few pretty good players left, like you mentioned GG Leos, but yeah, looking in prime position, only 4 players left. You know, once he gets to the... He's already in the top 4 of the winner's bracket. So, yeah, looking forward to seeing potentially more of him in the future. But we are going to have, I believe, 7 matches of today. And we're going to go to a break and see our next match coming up with Mauro and TJ. So stick around, guys. You don't want to miss it.